One holy church in which 19th chapter. The people of Israel set out from Rephidim and came into the wilderness of the Sinai, and they encamped in the wilderness. Then Israel encamped before the mountains when Moses went up to God. The Lord called to him out of the mountain, saying,
thank you. being saved by His love. More than that, we also rejoice in God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have now received reconciliation. Therefore, just as sin came into the world through one man, and death through sin, and so death spread to all men because all sin. For sin indeed was in the world before the law was given. But sin is not counted where there is no law, yet death reigns from Adam to Moses. Even over those who sin was not left to transgression to Adam, who was a type of the one who was to come. But the free gift is not left to trespass. For if many die through one man's trespass, much more have the grace of God and the free gift by the grace of that one man, Jesus Christ, this is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Sodom and Gomorrah, and for that time. Behold, I am sent.
understanding and so to speak. And some consider this gospel written to those with a Jewish background. And while each of the gospels is different, Matthew is one of the three that are called synoptic gospels because they view together, that's what the word means, the life and teachings of Jesus. That is Matthew, Mark, and Luke. John is it. Well, I want to make clear, the gospel writers were not just memorializing the deeds and the teachings of a revered but deceased master. They are explaining the universal significance of the life and death of someone that they proclaim to be still alive and knowable. They were evangelizing, that is, passing on good news. And that's where the reading begins for this day. Jesus is going out to all the cities and villages teaching, proclaiming that the kingdom of God is near, healing every disease. So what is the relevance of this account to us? After all, we're in the midst, I don't know if you're aware of it, a pandemic. And there's a certain amount of social unrest out there. You've seen the news.
What does it mean
1 says, all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. But there are moments when the kingdom of God comes as mentioned, certainly in our confessional writings. The kingdom of God comes. It comes when one gives a cup of cool water to another and thirsts, or when one is asked to walk a mile with another and they go to. When one cares about the most vulnerable among us and does not expect anything for it. When one thinks about how they might be going about engaging the world. Despite all of the things that can get in the way, the kingdom of God comes to us when one gives of themselves for others. You see that in the gospel reading as Jesus sends out his apostles, the sent ones. The only time Matthew will call them apostles. You were given freely, so give freely. And of course, the one who's proclaiming this message and the sending is the one who gave himself for each and every one of us. While we were still weak, Christ died for us. By one man, sin entered the world. And by one man, the free gift of grace entered the world in Christ Jesus. And we are given that gift. Now, this one who gave us that gift calls us. For we're told the kingdom of God is near. It's here for us to show those around us. As I said, the word used in the gospel, the apostle, the ones who are sent. We are sent into the world, not to the condemnation, but to show the love of God in Christ. To show those around us. That can be a challenge in any age. For me, it is very easy. It is so easy for me to identify those that are unlovable. Those who are perpetrating violence. Those who perpetrate injustice, hate, destruction. And I find it very easy to stand in judgment. I can judge. I'm good at it. If that's not my call, my call, just as you are, to show the love of God in Christ for this world. Caring for people, forgiving people, and loving people. Despite them at times trying to take advantage of me, and especially when they're not worthy of forgiveness, and they're not worthy of my love. Then that's how I am. While still a sinner, Christ died for me. I'm among the people who was reconciled with God through life, death, and resurrection of Jesus. It's a gift. Not just to be out, but to be passed on. The peace of God which surpasses all human understanding in your heart, and it lies in Christ Jesus.
Amen.
I invite you now to rise. Face one another as we confess our common Christian faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God.
Suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was
wisdom, make us into a blessing. Lord, in mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For people who want to learn, but have no teacher, and some who have much to teach, but no one to listen to them. Guide me, God, make us into a blessing. Lord, in mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For those who have been forced to retire too early, and for those who are overworked and long for retirement, God of rest and refreshment, make us into a blessing. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For some people who are famous, yet long for some privacy, and some who are lonely, and long for recognition and company, consoling God, make us into a blessing. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For those who are too tender-hearted and need to be tough, and for those who are tough and need to be made gentle, God, who is our Father, make us into a blessing. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For the wounded and diseased who have inadequate care, and for the tender who turn ill health into an obsession, healing, Lord, make us into a blessing. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For people who are dying with no one to mourn them, and for those who mourn with no one to comfort them, loving God, make us into a blessing. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For all who are least cheerful in the midst of poverty and great pain and death, and for those who are disgruntled in spite of plenty and good thoughts, God of discernment, make us into a blessing. Blessed Father, you love all as one human family, yet deal with us individually as if we were the only child you have. Please give us your generous and practical spirit, and let our prayers be converted to deeds day by day. Lord, in mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Into your hands, O Lord, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks and praise.
It is indeed good, right, and salutary that we should at all times and all places give thanks to you, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Everlasting God, for the countless blessings so freely bestow on us and all creation. Above all, we give thanks for your boundless love shown to us when you sent your only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, into our flesh, and laid on him our sin, giving him to the death that he might not die eternally. Because he is now risen from the dead, and lives and reigns through all eternity, all who believe in him will overcome sin and death, and will rise again to new life. Therefore, with angels and archangels and all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify your glorious name, evermore praising you and saying,
my body given for you. This do for the remembrance of me. Same way also he took the cup and made a cup when he had given thanks and gave to them, saying, drink from it all of you. This cup is the New Testament, shed in my blood for the forgiveness of sin. This do as often as you drink from it for the remembrance of me. The peace of the Lord be with you all.
Amen.
strengthen us through the same in faith toward you and in fervent love for one another. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Lord, bless you and keep you. But you know, you can Okay.